Where is she? Where is that madwoman? Where is that deceitful Bohemian Delilah?
If you mean Miss Dennis, she's out buying presents for the boy.
Spoiling him rotten. My God, kids, you've been going to school.
Oh, yes, he has. To the Laboratory of Life.
The Laboratory of Life? That's not a school. It's the Garden of Eden. I dropped by the Barclay School to check on the kid's academic standing. Turns out he wasn't even enrolled. Never has been. So I've been searching through every low, half-baked school for the feeble mind in this town. And where do I find him? In the lowest of them all. There they were, a whole schoolroom of them. Boys, girls, teachers, romping around, stark naked. Would you put your child in a place like that?
I'm unmarried.
Oh, what a day, Lindsay. What a lovely, lovely day.
What a day is right. I haven't even had a chance to call my office.
Why, Mr. Babcock, what a surprise.
You're no more fit to raise a child than Jezebel.
Patrick, something's happened to my little love?
Get in here, you little heathen, you.
He's been hiding in the kitchen.
Oh. Patrick, what happened? We were just playing fish families.
Fish families?
Show me, darling. Well, Mrs. Devine and all the girls crouched down on the floor under the sun lamps and pretend to be girl fishes depositing their eggs in the sand. Then Mr. Devine and all the boys do what gentlemen fish do.
What could be more wholesome and natural?
Natural? It might be natural for a sardine.
I consider your conduct most dignified, Mr. Babcock.
At least I'm wearing a vest. I'm getting out of this combination nudist camp opium den before you make me look like the vice president in charge of free love.
Mr. Babcock, not front of the B.O.Y.
Tomorrow morning, personally, I'm putting this kid in boarding school, St. Boniface Academy, and he's going to stay there.
I'll do anything you say if you just let the child stay near me.
He goes, and he goes tomorrow.
But Mr. Babcock,
let's be reasonable about this.
I'm going to turn this kid into a decent, God-fearing Christian if I have to break every bone in his body. You have him ready by 7 o'clock sharp tomorrow morning, and kid, you better be wearing knickers.
I want to stay with you, Auntie B.
St. Boniface probably isn't that bad.
Agnes, take Patrick upstairs and get him ready for dinner.
We'll talk about it later, darling.
Mame, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
Mame, are you home? Have you talked to your stockbroker?
Oh, yes, I can see that you have.
What about her stockbroker?
Oh, haven't you heard? He's called me half a dozen times trying to locate the two of you.
What happened?
Oh, the bulls have done something terrible to the bears, or vice versa. Anyhow, nothing's worth anything anymore.
Don't you worry, Mame. I'm sure this is only something temporary.
Missy! Stockbroker wants to say hello before he jumped out of window!
How bad is it, Arthur? Everything? Mame, I'm afraid you're wiped out. We all are.
Oh, thank God I never set anything aside.
Who gives a damn about money?
I just lost my child.
What?
Patrick's trustee is sending him to some school in Massachusetts.
Oh, Mame, I know how you must feel.
I'll go right over to your stockbrokers to see if I can pick up the pieces.
Oh, Vera, what am I going to do?
I have the perfect solution.
The theater.
I don't know, I'll talk to JJ and tell him he's simply got to give you a part in my new show. And the Knockerbocker Bank is sure to let Patrick come back to you once they see that you've settled down into something steady. Like acting.
You're absolutely right, Vera. Oh, and if old Babcock still stands in the way, at least I'll be earning the money to fight him. Oh, it'll be like when we were in the chorus together.
I was never in the chorus.
About $500 a week to start, don't you think? Oh, and then there'll be a raise.
Oh, no, Mame, it's only a ribbon at the end of the last act.
Oh, I accept.
torture. Tell me about Ephira.
Oh, well, it's this terribly modern operetta about the Lady Astronomer.
So. I've always wanted to be a Lady Astronomer.
I'm the Lady Astronomer. You are off stage left, waiting for your very exciting entrance at the most climactic moment of the show.
Thank you.